Now let's finish our evaluation of what would happen with a cylindrical coordinate system. Let's start putting our pieces together. If I want to find my electric field, I'm going to be doing a surface integral, and my rho s is 7z. Well, there's no such thing as just a plain z in these equations. It's either zs or zp. Since we're talking about our source, it is a zs term. Now let's figure out what ds is. We're going to go back to table 3-1 in your textbook and look at what's varying on this outside surface. Is my radius varying? dr. No, dr is not varying because the radius is always a, so dr is equal to 0. How about phi and z? Yes, phi is varying as I can see here, and z is varying as I can see. So dr is the only term that's not equal to 0. Go look in the cylindrical coordinates column of your table 3-1, and you'll find that there is only one surface that's left as soon as you set dr equal to 0. The surface that is left is the r d phi dz. Now these are either s or p values, and since we're adding up the sources all the time, my ds term, my dl term, my dv term, these are all s values that I'm integrating. Notice that I have no vector here, and that's because I'm not integrating a vector quantity. Someone asked in class what would happen if we had a vector quantity. We'll be showing you that on the Biot of our law, so just be a little bit patient until then. Now we need to divide by 4 pi epsilon, and we need to put in our RSP term here. I'm going to cube it, and I'm going to write this as just the vector RSP, so that I can simply substitute this in here and substitute that in there. This cubed term is the same thing as having my unit vector term that's been divided by its magnitude. So right here is everything that we need to integrate. Notice that I have x, y, and z components for my electric field. What if I only wanted the y component? Well, I would leave out the x and z, simply substitute in this portion of the y component, do my integration, and I would have ended up with Ey. What if I wanted to have E phi? E phi doesn't show up in this at all, and that's because I have x, y, and z components. If instead I wanted an E phi term or an ER term, then I would need to go back to table 3-2 and simply convert the vector that I obtained from the rectangular coordinates back to the cylindrical coordinates. So depending on what you're looking for, you may or may not need to do a conversion twice in this cylindrical evaluation. The first conversion, and that's almost inevitable, is that you have to do a conversion from the spherical coordinate system to the rectangular coordinate system so that you can do distances. The second possible conversion would be if you wanted to get cylindrical fields instead of rectangular fields. Now let's talk about one other possibility. What if I did a line vector, such as maybe just the top edge of this? What if I put a special charge around the top edge of the cylinder? How would things change? Would my RS term change for that line? Well, it certainly would. What would happen here is these two terms would stay the same, but ZS would be defined. In this case, ZS would equal 4. So every place that ZS showed up in my equations, it would be equal to 4. Pretty simple change. It would just make some change in my integration. Now what if this were a spherical coordinate system instead of a cylindrical coordinate system? I would do essentially the same steps, except right here, when I'm doing my conversion, I would convert from the spherical terms to the rectangular terms. Other than that, all of my steps would be identical. The ds term that I would choose would need to be the one that was appropriate for the spherical coordinate system. Now let me remind you of one important fact here. It is not essential that my values be uniform here. For instance, I could have integrated only half of this cylinder. Suppose that I had only half a cylinder instead of a full cylinder. This is a very important distinction because when we get to Gauss's law, I could not handle half a cylinder in Gauss's law, only in Coulomb's law.